Who are you?
I'm just someone trying to do my job before it's too late.
I don't understand.
You don't have a lot of time, Anna.
Wait. I remember I was on my way home from an audition, and then that asshole in that Prius crashed into me. Shit, am I dead?
That's up to you.
What is that? Am I in hell?
Do I look like a hellhound to you? You have 5 minutes to tell me that your life is worth something.
What happens if we run out of time?
You're gonna die. Anna, focus. What was the last thought you had?
Oh shit.
Before that.
I don't know.
You were comparing yourself to other women in the room.
Yeah. Yeah, I was thinking that there were 50 other prettier, skinnier women in this room that probably deserved the part more than I did.
And then someone called you after that.
My
right?
husband. My husband. He asked me why I took a shift off work when we needed the money.
Then what?
And then I was thinking that it was a waste of time sitting in this LA traffic when there are 12 million other people who have someplace to go at the same damn time.
So all that is what led you here.
I was leaving an audition when the accident happened.
You were?
So is this your way of telling me to let go of some childhood fantasy?
No. If that were the case, you wouldn't be here right now.
I just want to be seen.
You have less than 2 minutes left.
There's not enough time.
There's always enough time. Maybe you just don't know what to do with it.
You're right. I don't know. Seven years ago, I put up a one-act play in this little hole-in-the-wall theater in Springfield, Missouri. This was a prop. It was our last night, and this girl, she's maybe 15 years old, just gushed out at me. And she said, "You have the ability to make people feel things deeply." So I kept this ring, you know, because it reminds me of that. It was the biggest compliment I ever received. And then in that moment, I was seen. And I allowed myself to stop chasing a childhood fantasy. God, my heart fills up when I get to open it to the world.